നമസ്കാരം. എൻ ടി വിയുടെ ലോകമെമ്പാടുമുള്ള എല്ലാ മാന്യ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്കും ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടി ഹൃദയം നിറഞ്ഞ പുതുവർഷ ആശംസകൾ നേരുകയാണ്. പതിവ് പോലെ ഈ വർഷം 2018 ഏറ്റവും മികച്ച ഒരു തുടക്കം തരാനായിട്ട് തന്നെ വളരെ എനർജറ്റിക് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു പേഴ്സണാലിറ്റിയാണ് ഇന്ന് അതിഥിയായി നമ്മൾ കൊണ്ടുവന്നിരിക്കുന്നത്. മറ്റാരുമല്ല, ഡാൻസ് റിയാലിറ്റി ഷോയിലൂടെ ജഡ്ജായും കൊറിയോഗ്രാഫറായും ഡാൻസറായും ഒക്കെ മലയാളികളുടെ മനസ്സ് കീഴടക്കിയ മലയാളിയല്ലാത്ത നമ്മുടെ സ്വന്തം നീരവ് ബവേജയാണ്. അദ്ദേഹമാണ് ഇന്ന് അതിഥിയായിട്ട് നമ്മുടെ ഒപ്പം ഉള്ളത്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ വിശേഷങ്ങളിലേക്ക് കടക്കാം. നീരവ് ഭായ്, സ്വാഗതം.
താങ്ക് യു, താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച്.
എന്തൊക്കെയുണ്ട് വിശേഷങ്ങൾ?
ഓക്കെ, സോ വാട്ട് എവർ യു സ്പോക്ക് ഇൻ മലയാളം, ഐ ഡിഡ് അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദ സെക്കൻഡ് പാർട്ട്. എനിക്ക് കുറച്ച് കുറച്ച് മലയാളത്തിൽ സംസാരിക്കും ട്രൈ ചെയ്യാം, പക്ഷേ ഒരുപാട് മിസ്റ്റേക്സ് ആണ്.
Slowly you're picking the Malayalam,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Because everyone knows the world's most two toughest language, one is Chinese and one is Malayalam.
Well, I think only one language. I think I can still talk in Chinese, ni hao. In Malayalam is very difficult to talk.
Yeah.
It's a tongue twister more than a difficult. I think it's a tongue twister.
Exactly. Yeah.
But I think by it's been okay. I'm going to try this in Malayalam. Moon varshai naan Kerala till ജഡ്ജാണ്,
പക്ഷേ
കുറച്ച് കുറച്ച് മലയാളം പഠിക്കുന്നു. കറക്റ്റ്,
പഠിച്ചു
വരുന്നു. ഒരുപാട് ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ട് ലാംഗ്വേജ് ആണ്. പക്ഷേ ഞാൻ പ്രോമിസ് മൈസെൽഫ് 2018 കംപ്ലീറ്റ് മലയാളം, ഐ ഷുഡ്
ഫുൾ ഫ്ലെഡ്ജ്
മലയാളം. സൂപ്പർ ആയ,
വെരി ഗുഡ്, വെരി ഗുഡ്, വെരി ആ സ്പിരിറ്റ് ആണ്,
അതാണ്, ദാറ്റ്സ് എ സ്പിരിറ്റ്.
എക്സാക്ട്ലി. നൗ വി ആർ ഇൻ ദ 2018.
Correct.
What are your new year resolutions? What are the plans?
So I generally don't make any new year resolutions as such, but yes, this year I've made one that I'll be learning Malayalam.
Okay.
And apart from that, I always go with the flow. I don't plan myself, but always believe in hard working and just give your best shot every day. When you get up in the morning, every day should be a new day. Every day you should celebrate as a new year. And that's how you're going to keep your energy and your life going on.
Okay. You know, as a dance professional, choreographer, dancer, you know, how you are learning the new steps, or you know, it's you are watching a lot of international acts, or you yourself inventing new dance steps. How was that?
Okay, I'll be honest, not inventing as such a new dance style, but you have to keep watching international dance styles to keep yourself updated. Because you know, as you know, the technology, you can't still have an iPhone Nokia in your hand when the iPhone generation or the Android generation. So yes, you have to keep updating yourself. So I keep watching a lot of videos and definitely add my personal touch to the songs which I choreograph or the songs which I perform to it, because that will make it different rather than, you know, the similar looking stuff.
Correct. You know, for season, you are a part of one of the best, the dance reality show. And you've gone through so many, experience. You met so many people, the directors and film related people, and what was the most memorable thing during this journey?
I think for me, the entire 4 years or 4 seasons or 4.5 seasons actually, because D1 happened, then D2 happened, then D3 happened, then D4 Dance Reloaded happened, and then D4. So it's been like quite a lot of journey, and almost every season had 120 episodes. So every season had a different flavor to it, and was most memorable stuff happened. So whether it was the contestants performing a different acts, whether it was watching live classical performances like Kathakali, which I thought I would never watch it when I was in Mumbai, and obviously the selection part, the elimination part of the show. So every time when we went through the process, everything was memorable for me. I think it's been a life changer, I would say, when it comes to Kerala, because as everybody knows, being non-Malayali and being a judge in a dance reality show, to be there for 4 seasons, yes, in itself is a very great achievement, I would say.
Yes, Malayali people accept you.
Yes, I think all thanks to all the Malayali people for accepting me the way I am, and accepting me as a judge on the dance show and give me a lot of love and support. I think I've been very grateful to each one of them.
See, now what I notice is, during, as you mentioned, the 6 years ago, if I watch any dance reality show, we can see a lot of steps which is based on the ground. But now I can see so many aerial acts that's also considered as the dance. So how it will happen, how as a judge, how tough is that?
So okay, this was, I can kind of say that we kind of introduced the aerial dance in India. I'm not sure. I may be wrong in this, but you know, there was a show which I was a part of. It's called ZTV's Dance India Dance. Okay. And season one in 2008, that was the first time we introduced something called an aerial dance in a ring. Just wanted you to take dance to a different level. To be honest, it's basically a circus.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a circus. Okay. But getting circus choreographed on a music along with the dance. So that's what we did, you know, and that's how aerial dance came into the picture. And we danced with fire, we have danced on ice, we have danced with a lot of prop elements and stuff like that, just to take dance on a different level and entertain people. And again, before, if you see, rewind yourself 5 years back and say that 99% of people used to dance on upbeat numbers. Okay, nobody used to dance on a sad number.
Exactly.
So we created a trend called contemporary dance. We did not create, there was already a contemporary dance, which we fitted on a sad music.
Okay.
Because in life, I believe when people are in love, they want to listen all to love songs.
Yeah.
And when they go through a breakup, they want to listen all to a sad songs.
Exactly.
And I think these are the more songs connected to people. Everybody once in a life must have fallen in love, whether it's your first crush in your school, right next to your bench, or it's on a teacher, or there's a breakup time where the girl says, no, I can't be with you, or I don't like you. That's where the boys or the girls, they feel demotivated, they want to listen all to the sad songs.
Exactly.
And when you somebody who performs on that, you immediately relate to it. That's how contemporary dance has become very popular among the dancers nowadays.
Okay.
I feel.
But the people like the normal dance lovers, especially the cinematic dance lovers or the normal dance lovers, how they are, you know, I think they won't be that much happy, because it's, as you mentioned, it's like a circus. So where is the dance element? People can find a dance element on a, you know, aerial circus kind of.
Okay. To be honest, I see dance in every movement of your body. It's dance. Okay. So, for example, people traveling in bus, you know, when they're moving forward and back, okay, if I put that to a rhythm, you know, that's a dance. So any movement of your body is dance. But yes, for us, expressing your feelings, whether you're feeling sad, whether you're feeling happy, whether you're excited, whether you're scared. So dance is basically a movement of expressions put to a music. Okay. And to take a dance to a different level, you know, that wow factor, when we say that, oh, your dance was okay, but that wow factor. Now, wow factor could be even a simple step, it could be a simple expression, or it could be something which people have never seen before. So I think, because when we come to a competition level, like dance reality shows, we add these elements to make the competition tougher, and so that the audience enjoy and something new.
Keralathile 4 varshayittu ippo Keralathil undu appo Keralathile ella sthalathum travel cheyidittundavum Trivandrum to maybe Kannur, Kozhikode, Ivasan alle appo ee sthalangalile sancharichappo aalkarude, so people are watching you, you know, entire Kerala, so people loves you a lot. So avarude oru response enganeyanu Neeravine kaanumbol?
The response has been really very good. And talking about the food, my favorite food, எனக்கு கடலக்கறி புட்டு வளர இஷ்டம். ஸோ ஐ திங்க் கடலக்கறி அண்ட் புட்டு இஸ் சம்திங் விச் ஐ ரியலி என்ஜாய். அண்ட் ஆம் அ வெஜிடேரியன். ஸோ லாட் ஆஃப் பீப்பிள் டெல் மீ தட், ஓ யூ டோன்ட் நோ வாட் ஆர் யூ மிஸ்ஸிங், யூ ஹாவ் டு ஹேட் மலபாரி பிரியாணி, நைச்சோர் அண்ட் சிக்கன் கறி அண்ட் பீஃப் கறி அண்ட் ஸ்டஃப் லைக் தட். பட் ஐ ஆம் அ வெஜிடேரியன், ஸோ ஐ என்ஜாய் ஃபுட். ஐ எம் நாட் அ வெரி ஃபஸி பர்சன் ஆஸ் ஃபார் ஆஸ் ஓகே. தேர் ஆர் டூ பீப்புள், தேர் ஆர் ஃபியூ பீப்புள் ஹூ லிவ் to eat.
Okay.
Okay. I am the person, I eat to live.
Live. Okay. That's a good one.
Yeah.
So, the sweets, chocolate, ice cream,
I'm not a big fan of chocolate ice creams and all. As I said, I'm not a foodie. So it's not like, oh, brownie, you know, oh, ice cream. I don't crave for it.
Okay.
So which is okay.
Okay. See, Keralathil oripada salangal travel cheyidittund. So Mumbai-il ninnu oru metropolitan city-il ninnu Keralathilekku varumbol endanu oru difference feel cheythu 4 varsham ippo Keralathil
ninnu? People in Mumbai are machines.
Okay.
Okay. And people in Kerala knows how to live a life.
Okay.
After 6 o'clock, they all want to leave all the work.
Okay.
They have, I don't know whether I can say it or no.
Okay.
They want to enjoy their time.
Okay.
After 6 o'clock, all the men want to just be themselves,
okay,
enjoy themselves, spend time with the family.
Mm-hmm.
They don't really stress out, because people in Mumbai, we work like machines, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Half of the time, as rightly said, goes in traveling,
mm-hmm,
or you have to work till 10 in the night.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very mechanical life.
Mm-hmm.
And somewhere it's more soulful life. The places, a lot of greenery. I think I must say, I've traveled to a lot of places in India.
Mm-hmm.
I think the most amount of greenery and the most amount of nature is in Kerala.
Kerala.
In terms of coconut trees, in terms of hill stations, in terms of beaches. So there is lots more to see in Kerala.
4 varshayittu Keralathilund. Of course, a lot of fan following, especially girls. Adippo namukku aa reality show itself namukku kaanam. Girls are sending letters, you know, the bouquet, chocolates, heart shapes. So atharathil serious aayittulla oru love aarodukku thonittundo?
Nobody has walked up to me and really said that I want to marry you or something like that.
Agana paranjal, if anybody approach you like that.
No, I don't know. If anybody approaches, I feel today, in today's world till now, it's time for me. I think a lot of people keep asking, when are you getting married? When are you getting married?
Okay.
No, you guys need to understand, I can't break everybody's heart. You know? Imagine marrying one person, making one person happy, I'll be breaking so many girls' heart.
That's a clever one. Yeah.
Yeah, so I think I prefer not to break anybody's heart, keep all of them happy.
Okay.
You know, that's
and you will choose.
I don't know whether I'll choose or no. I think I can't choose things. It will just happen. I believe
See,
that.
Why I ask this question, you know.
Okay, let me tell you. I've been liking people. I have a crush on people.
Okay.
Trust me, girls have said no to me. So I so I don't know whom to believe. When people say that, oh, you have a lot of girls who like you,
yeah,
who want to marry you.
Hmm.
But a girl who I like, or when I want to tell her that, oh, can you marry me? They say no.
Really?
Yeah, they have said, it's happened with me.
And from Kerala or?
That's a secret.
That's a secret. See, why I ask this question, because നമ്മളിപ്പോ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു സെലിബ്രിറ്റി വന്നിട്ട് അവരെ കൂടെ ഡാൻസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോഴും കണ്ണിൽ വല്ലാത്തൊരു കെമിസ്ട്രി ഉണ്ട്, ഒരു അട്രാക്ഷൻ. സോ അത്തരത്തിൽ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു സെലിബ്രിറ്റിയോടോ ആരോടെങ്കിലും ഒരു ക്രഷ്?
My friends don't believe so, you know, on the show. I said, no, how can you not fall in love with anybody out there? So many beautiful girls come on your show, they promote. I said, yeah, but you know, when I'm performing, in my head somewhere I know that I'm performing.
Okay.
And it's not that, you know, that you say ki jab ladki dekhti to dil mein guitar bajne lagti hai, hawaye chalne lagti. Nothing that sort of has happened till now.
Okay.
In that typical Bollywood or filmy scene. But let's see, I think it just happens. You can't go and approach. I've been told by a lot of people that when it has to happen the right time, it will automatically happen. It will automatically click. The hearts will automatically get connected.
Okay.
So I don't know when, I'm just still waiting.
Shape is coming automatically. Endana demand? Or a dream girl aaram?
Okay, so there is no demand as such. It's a very simple policy. In field which I am, the girl has to have a faith and trust on me and needs to understand my lifestyle. When I say my lifestyle is that, I'm a workaholic.
Okay.
The only thing which keeps me happy is work. If I'm working, if I'm busy, then I'm the most happiest person on the world.
Okay.
I don't need anything else. So that's one, she needs to understand that work is it. I'm not saying that I won't.
Your busy life, basically.
My busy life.
Yeah.
Yeah, and obviously when I dance with other girls, like how I dance on D4, she can't get jealous.
Okay.
So that she needs to understand that's my work.
That's only an act.
Yeah. So those things, if somebody understands, I think then becomes much more easier. The life will be smooth enough for both of us.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's always going to be a clash.
Okay, so Bombay or Kerala, there is no problem. Right
it
person?
It could be from China, it could be from Europe, it could be from anywhere.
Okay. Then a controversy question. See, Neerav from Mumbai. And we Malayalis accept you like, you know, it's nammada or family member na pole.
Absolutely.
This same acceptance ivda ninnu oru dancer allengu oru dance director northilottu poi kaniyal avarku kittu.
I think most of your people in Bollywood industry, I would say the technicians are from the south industry.
Okay.
Because I think they're technically so sound, they're technically so brilliant that we don't have any issues in accepting. I think recently it's a very big achievement, I would say. Parvati Menon has done a film with Irfan Khan.
Yeah.
People die to work with Irfan Khan in Bollywood, being such a main actor who's done Hollywood films.
That's true.
And she's got a chance. So I'm sure people have accepted that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not about from where you are. It's about your work. It's about how you want to present. So I think I don't think so. In India, at least we have that North and South versus.
As
the best example is Kerala. They have accepted me.
Exactly.
You know, being a non-Malayali,
yeah,
I've been there for 4 years. I think that itself talks that there's nothing like that.
Any other toughest question lot to pona? This question, either celebrity or chodichalum, they won't give the clear answer. So Kerala thali pa 4 varshai, 4 years, alle. Oru baadu Malayala cinema andittundavum. Oru Malayala cinema le dafedar nu vanna cinema da baaga aittundu, alle. Tinu Tom chattanle kude.
Okay.
മലയാള സിനിമയിൽ രണ്ട് സൂപ്പർ സ്റ്റാറുകളുണ്ട്, മമ്മൂട്ടി മോഹൻലാൽ. രണ്ടുപേരും മലയാളികളുടെ റൈറ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് ലെഫ്റ്റ് ഹാൻഡ് പോലെയാണ്. നീരവിന് ആരെയാണ് കൂടുതൽ ഇഷ്ടം?
ഓക്കെ, ഐ ആം ഗോയിങ് ടു ബി വെരി ഓണസ്റ്റ്. വെൻ ഐ സേ ഓണസ്റ്റ്, The first film which I saw in Malayalam was Drishyam.
Okay.
Okay. And like amazing script, amazing direction, amazing acting.
Mm.
And then of course after that I saw a lot of other movies. So this was nice. Then I was told that, to be honest, I'll be very honest, like I used to watch very few South Indian films. Of course, Rajni sir, everybody knows, so you know, there was that. Mahesh Babu I knew, then Dhanush I knew, Allu Arjun, because of the dancing also of Allu Arjun, Junior NTR. So during the Malayalam cinema, I had no clue.
Okay.
And then people asked me, do you know Mohanlal and do you know Mammootty? And I said, no, but I watched the movie. Then I watched, after telling people, then I watched even Mammootty sir's movie and all. I think Godfather was the movie. He's done one film.
Yeah, Godfather. Great Father.
The Great Father.
Mm.
So a couple of movies I've seen. I've seen Dulkar Salman's movie. And then I thought, yes, obviously the Malayalam cinema focuses more on story and performance. You know, it's very acting oriented films. It's not commercial in terms of how we have in Bollywood that we add few more songs, we add dance sequence and the story can be anything. And the movie still does well.
Exactly.
I think Malayalam cinema is the only one cinema counting, knowing all, I'm talking about in Marathi, Bengali, Bhojpuri, Gujarati, Orissa, counting all these movies, the strongest story lineup would be of Malayalam. I may be wrong, but this is my perception, my,
you're right,
my
absolutely
point of view.
Right, yeah.
So I think both of them has great fan following, very different personality as such.
You met them?
Yes, I've met Mammooka sir for when I was doing a Red FM Awards, Music Awards.
Okay.
I met him that time. I have not met Mohanlal sir yet.
Okay. Samsaricha, Mammooka sir, Mammooka ayittu samsaricha.
Yes, I said hi to him. I shook hands with him. And then he was just leaving and I was entering.
Okay.
So that was the point I've met him.
Okay.
And apart from that, yet to meet the Jimmicky Kamal man.
Okay. So, churikam paranja Mammooka Mohanlal oru pole ishtam.
Yeah, I like
rendu
pere. Apart from that, I like Nivin Poli also. I've seen Premam.
Okay.
Then I like Fahad Fasil. Okay. I've seen his movie.
Fahad vannirunnu oru thavana.
Yes, twice he's come. Okay. We've met... So that is one. Then I've met, not met, but I've seen, which is that movie? Dulkar Salman's movie I've seen. I've seen Bangalore Days.
Okay.
So that movie also really enjoyed.
Very good.
So there are a lot of movies I've seen in Malayalam which I've enjoyed. In spite of not knowing the language and still understanding the story.
Okay.
That means it's very well directed.
Subtitle
alone. No, not subtitle. Okay. So with me, when I watch Malayalam films, I may laugh at the joke which everybody's laughing at.
Okay.
I may not laugh at each and every dialogue.
Okay.
I may not whistle at each and every dialogue.
Okay.
But I get a gist of it. I get the story lineup. I know the film is about... I have seen Takeoff. And then I was in fact fighting from a person from Bollywood saying that it's complete. The story has been lifted from Takeoff. It's already a Malayalam film which I saw.
Yeah.
And Tiger Zinda is based on that story.
Exactly.
So
correct.
So it feels really proud that I am from a city. So when I go right now in Bombay, I said, oh, you should watch in Kerala. So they feel that, okay, I've been like completely now Kerala boy and you know.
Exactly, exactly.
So that's how been it.
Our flavor vandu thodangi Malayali.
Yes, I have. See, I appreciate anything which is a good, you know. I strongly believe that every Malayali has two things in common. It's born either with a singing talent or with a mimicry talent. So it's known the place for talent. So that's two things. And now obviously after D4 dance, people can dance also.
Exactly.
So singing, dancing and mimicry are the three things which every Kerala person is born with.
Okay, okay. Nammalippo ivideyanu UAE-il Dubai-il appo ivide idinu munpu vannittundo, or this is first time?
No, I've been to Dubai, UAE for a couple of times for shows only, to be honest. I've performed, I've interacted with people. So it's been really great experience knowing that how a lot of people from India have come here and been settled for ages, like 30 years, 25 years away from your hometown and still making a place, look, feel, food-wise, everything, still a feeling of Kerala.
Exactly.
I think a lot of love and support from here. So all the people who are staying here have been really grateful or have been really warm enough to greet me every time when I've come here. So thanks to all of them. Yes, people do recognize. As I said, when I be to the malls and when I go in Kerala also, because I don't dress up every day in jackets,
okay,
the way I dress up on the show.
Okay.
So they take some time. Oh, is that Neerav ji? They discuss.
Okay.
By the time they decide and they are very sure, I'm already passed from there.
Okay, okay.
Some people follow running behind. They come to lift. They want one selfie. You know, can we have an autograph? Can we have a picture?
Okay.
So it feels really nice about it. That
jacket buying is standard, no?
I really like
a collection than a jacket.
Yes, I do have a collection of around 150 jackets.
Oh my god.
Around 150 jackets.
Okay, okay.
Jackets is something I love. The reason is that I don't like cold countries.
Mm.
I can't take cold weather so much.
Okay.
If you put me in a hot weather, if you put me in a desert in the middle of Dubai and say stay
there, you are okay.
I'm okay. But if you put me in Canada and say stay in snow, I will die.
Okay.
So I think that's the reason I like to keep myself warm and I like jackets.
Okay. Okay. Costumes okay, sondayittu select cheyyunnano.
Yeah, I think sometimes I go wrong, sometimes I think people like it.
Mm-hmm.
But this is my personal
Even the reality show illulla ella costumes your own.
My personal.
Oh, okay.
That's my all personal clothes and my personal
okay.
way of dressing up as well.
Mm-hmm. Ivda naattil ninnu ivide ettumbo ivide illa oru pravasi malayaligalde nammal malayaligalde aa oru sneham rendinum difference feel cheyidirunno ivide illa aalu kaanumbo കൂടുതൽ നീരം അങ്ങനെ കൂടുതൽ അവരുടെ ഒരു ഇഷ്ടത്തിൽ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡെപ്ത്തിൽ ഡിഫറൻസ് തോന്നിയിരുന്നു
നോട്ട് ഡിഫറൻസ് ആസ് സച്ച് ബട്ട് ഐ ബിലീവ് ദാറ്റ് ഐ ഹവ് ട്രാവൽ ടു ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് കൺട്രീസ് വെയർ ഇന്ത്യൻസ് ഹു ബീൻ സ്റ്റേയിങ് അവേ ഫ്രം ദ കൺട്രി ഹോം കൺട്രി ദ ഹവ് എ വെരി ഡിഫറെന്റ് വേ ഓഫ് ഗ്രീറ്റിംഗ് ബിക്കോസ് യു നോ ദ ഫീൽ ദാറ്റ് സംബഡി ഫ്രം ദർ ഫാമിലീസ് കം ബാക്ക് ടു ദ കൺട്രി ഈസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു ടോക്ക് അബൌട്ട് സംതിങ് സോ ദാറ്റ് ഡിഫറെന്റ് ഫീലിംഗ് ഇസ് ഓൾറെഡി ദേർ ബട്ട് വെൻ ഐ സേ നോട്ട് ആസ് സച്ച് ദാറ്റ് ഓ ദ ട്രീറ്റ്മെന്റ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ഡിഫറെന്റ് ഇസ് ദി എക്സൈറ്റ്മെന്റ് ഓഫ് സംബഡി കമ്മിങ് ഫ്രം ഹോം ദാറ്റ് എക്സൈറ്റ്മെന്റ് ഇസ് ഓൾറെഡി ദേർ സോ ദാറ്റ് ഐ നോട്ടീസ് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ദാറ്റ്
നമുക്ക് വൈൻഡ് അപ്പ് ചെയ്യേണ്ട ടൈം ആവുന്നു സോ നാവ് ഞാൻ എല്ലാം മലയാളത്തിലാണ് ചോദിക്കുന്നത് സോ നാവ് you understand malayalam alle
I understand I understand and I think my as I said before we started that 2018 for the next season of D4 dance if I'm there as a judge my biggest challenge and my biggest commitment to my own self is going to be that me learning malayalam and talking in malayalam yes
2018 ആയിരിക്കുകയാണ് 2018 പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ മറ്റൊരു സീസണ് വേണ്ടി കാത്തിരിക്കുന്നു ഒപ്പം നീരവിന്റെ മനസ്സിൽ ഒരു സിനിമ ഉണ്ട് എന്നാണ് നമ്മൾ സംസാരിച്ചപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലാക്കുന്നത് എന്താണ് ആ ഒരു പ്രോജക്റ്റ്
സോ ഓക്കേ സോ ആഫ്റ്റർ D4 dance getting very popular enough I've got people calling me that you know would you like to act in films and to be honest somewhere my this was my dream ages back I want to be an actor
okay.
but then certain things you have to accept I'm not a tall looking person I don't have a great build like a you know that macho look for Bollywood industry
okay.
but if something which is in terms of dance which is more youth which is more college based which does not require very acting oriented character then definitely I'm open to it
okay.
so like exactly like how Remo De Souza made a movie on ABCD2 ABCD1 and ABCD2 based on dancer's life if somebody in Malayalam wants to make something on the similar line then I'm only open to it
adu direct cheyan vendittano adile act cheyan vendittano ed role aanu
no I want to act first
okay.
and director I'm not sure as if I've never thought of being a director I want to be a part of it I do have a story so I like formatting shows I like putting things together I like forming projects when I say projects in terms of okay reality show formats it could be not compulsory dance based it could be anything so I'm more keen on formatting things so that's the reason I have a story lineup if somebody wants to write it somebody wants to direct it somebody wants to produce it
okay.
I'm on
ready
for it
kelkana producers nak niravaya samivikavunnathana adeyathin itharathil dance reality show ka base cheyidittulla story lineup
alle because a lot of people think that it's rigged you know people this you know how it is they believe that oh it's all partiality so you want to show real of it
okay.
that behind the scene what it happens
okay.
and I want to show in my story I can just say one line you know it generally happens once you're on a peak of a dance show for 4-5 years you make a lot of money you're popular you start spending and when your popularity goes down what happens after that
okay.
the life the struggle after being a celebrity and the downfall
okay downfall
and everybody has it
yeah.
you whether you want to believe it or no every actor every famous personality definitely has a downfall and then you have to struggle and back come up it's all it depends Amitabh Bachchan had it at one point you know KBC got him back I'm giving biggest example for Aamir Khan also after Lagaan there was a comeback
yeah.
you know so everybody has that second innings of the life
exactly
so
see adondaanu thonnu Neerabai ottiri popular aavanda oru mid range il ninnamadi nappalum anganeyano
see I don't count myself as a popular I count myself as a normal normal human being I would say
okay.
I don't count myself as a celebrity one of the reason that I also have one nose, two eyes, one lips, two ears, two hands.
Okay.
There's nothing special.
Okay.
Yes, the only special thing is that the love I get from people. So maybe for someone only 5 or like hundreds of people, thousands of people, lakhs of people love me.
Yeah.
That's the only difference I get. For me, I believe that I want to spread smiles to a lot of people's faces. So being required, if I'm dancing or even if I'm cracking stupid jokes, if that makes people laugh, then that's something which I want to do it
okay
and celebrity status is very short I don't call myself as a celebrity I'm a normal person and I dance and I entertain people. That's
excellent. Excellent. That's so nice of you. Nalla vaakkukal. Endayalum namukku wind up cheyanda oru vaadu chodyangal chodikkanundu. Pakshe namukku wind up cheyanda samayam aayathondu maathram niruthukayanu. NTV logam embaadum oru vaadu prekshakarulla UAE-il ulla ഏക ലൈവ് എച്ച് ഡി തത്സമയ മലയാളം ചാനലാണ്. പ്രേക്ഷകരോട് എന്താണ് പറയാനുള്ളത്?
സോ ഓൾ ദ വ്യൂവേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് എൻ ടി വി, ഐ വാണ്ട് ടു വിഷ് എൻ്റെ ഹൃദം നിറഞ്ഞ 2018 ആശംസകൾ.
ഹൃദം നിറഞ്ഞതും ദാറ്റ്സ് നൈസ്, ബട്ട് ദ ഒറിജിനൽ വേർഡ് ഈസ് ഹൃദയം. ഹൃദയം
ഹൃദയം നിറഞ്ഞ 2018 വിഷിംഗ് ഈച്ച് വൺ ഓഫ് യു ലോട്ട്സ് ഓഫ് സക്സസ്, ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഹാപ്പിനെസ്, കീപ് സ്മൈലിംഗ്, കീപ് ഡാൻസിംഗ് ആൻഡ് കീപ് റോക്കിംഗ്. And yes, happy new year.
ഒരുപാട് സ്ട്രഗിൾ ചെയ്തിട്ടാണ് നീരവ് ഭായ് ഈ ഒരു ലെവലിൽ എത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നത്. സോ ഇനി ഈ ഫീൽഡിലേക്ക് വരുന്ന ഡാൻസേഴ്സ് ആവട്ടെ, കൊറിയോഗ്രാഫേഴ്സ് ആവട്ടെ, അവരോട് എന്താണ് പറയാനുള്ളത്, ഒരു ടിപ്പ്?
Okay, there's a very simple formula of life. Forget about getting into dancing or this. Anything what you love to do, which keeps you happy, do that. Trust me, you don't want to work for... I'm not saying money is not important, as I've already said. It is important for today's life. But as far as... if you're happy and satisfied doing something, always give your 100%. Be disciplined, be passionate enough. At least give a try in life. You should not feel that, oh shit, if I would have tried 10 years back, maybe I would have been that. That feeling might be different. So I would say for all the viewers who are watching, if you believe in something, if you like something, if you're passionate about something, whether it could be a opening of a business, whether it could be a job, whether it could be anything, just give your best shot, give your best. And I think, trust me, rest, leave it up to him. If you believe in God, I do believe a lot in God, and everything will fall in place.
Exactly.
I think everybody's destiny is written. You just need to work towards it.
Okay. So, അതുപോലെ NTV കാണുന്ന ഒരുപാട് പെൺകുട്ടികൾ ഉണ്ടാവും. നീരവായി ബാച്ചലർ ആണ്. അവർക്ക് എന്താണ് പറയാ? അവരോട് എന്താ പറയാനുള്ളത്?
So, life is very better. Trust me, are you married?
Yeah.
So how is the life for you?
Good.
He's good? He's being very... he's just been very safe right now because Chechi at home is going to, you know, check on him. But I would say all the people there just keep smiling for me. I don't know. I don't want...
send the letters.
No, nothing. Yeah. I don't want anybody to send me letters. As I said, I don't want to break anybody's heart. So, you know, just be there. Keep loving me. Keep supporting me.
But they have that sign.
Yeah, so that's the sign for each one of you that my heart is always beating for you guys. And this is my signature step for all the girls out
there. That's nice. Okay. So once again, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, you too.
Thank you.